Hello, I'm Roland Gordon, and thank you for watching the OPT3101 Configurator Tool training video. In this video, I will highlight exactly why the OPT3101 Configurator Tool is easy to use and very powerful. If you do not already have the tool in your PC, you can download it at ti.com/OPT3101. Then, click on the Tools and Software tab to find the download link. The tool itself is an offline GUI form that lets the user choose the way that the OPT3101 base system needs to be configured. It provides a high level of abstraction to the user where all the underlying register settings that are required for device initialization and configuration are calculated by the tool. The output of the tool is a header file for the OPT3101 SDK. The tool has several sections that lets the user customize the system settings based on the application. The General Device Settings section allows the user to adjust the frame count, maximum ambient current support setting, continuous frequency correction mode, and more. The TX selector setting, located on the right side of the interface, allows you to select the illumination current desired. Based on application requirements, you are able to select up to two additional emitters and select which order you would like to sequence through. The Monoshock setting on the top left corner of the tool lets the user enable Monoshock mode. This mode is a low power mode that, when enabled, puts the device in a deep sleep state and waits for an external trigger. You can adjust the number of frames per shot as well as the power up delay. With auto HDR mode enabled, the device switches between two illumination driver currents to extend the dynamic range, depending on the signal saturation and lower amplitude threshold. The auto HDR scale can be modified as well as the high threshold, while the low threshold and low illumination current settings are automatically scaled. When super HDR mode is enabled, the on-chip sequencer is used to extend the dynamic range using four illumination currents. Automatically, two transmitters are selected in the TX selector settings section, and the illumination current's lower thresholds are changed according to the super HDR ratio. If you hover over user entry fields or over parameter labels, diagrams and tooltips will be displayed in the info display section at the bottom of the screen. By design, the GUI form allows the user to enter the desired configuration, but ensures that only a valid configuration for OPT3101 can be entered. Once the desired configuration is entered, it can be saved, which is useful to restore settings or compile different settings. And finally, by pressing the Create Configuration C++ file button, the required C++ file that is used for initialization in the SDK is generated. This C++ file is a crucial element to configure the system on power-up and set flags and variables for calibration. To access all the tools and documents that we created to help you prototype easier and faster, visit ti.com/OPT3101. If you need technical support with OPT3101, visit ti.com/support, where you will find a variety of ways to connect with us. Thanks for watching.